What is going on, my friends? Today we have an Analyzer Random. Basically, this is a video where I try to help you guys improve at Call of Duty or any FPS game, because a lot of things can be applied to other games, along with try to analyze one random player matchmaking that I find that I run up against and I pick a game from them. Today we have Ambikins, using a sniper and a 5.7 pistol, shock charge, C4, the low streaks, basically what you'd expect, UAV, hunter killer, and the supply drop. And then also using lightweight fast hands, tac masks. Shock charge is the ability to basically camp up here and kind of play slow. Watches the other window, which is really good if you're going to snipe, because you have to watch the top part first. That's the best way to do it. Also, a smart play while they do this is they crouch. This kind of makes it easier for them to not get, or makes it harder for people on the ground to see it into the window and shoot them. So it is useful. Picks up the kill there, which is really good. Then kind of does what I think is really smart here. A lot of people don't do this, but I do it as well, kind of subconsciously. And I'm going to mention it. So if you pick a point on the ground, why can I not fucking move is the question. I'm just gonna do this real quick. There we go. It's like I can't get off the free cam, or into free cam mode. If you pick a point, to avoid being killed very easily, instead of standing at that area and then looking where you want to look, one of the best things you can do is kind of move in a figure eight pattern, you know? Just a figure eight. Left and right, left and right. And the point where the two loops meet, which is where the eight forms, is the point you actually want to be standing on. But when you're doing that, it makes it much harder for enemies to hit you with consecutive shots. So, you'll see them do it right here, like that. Like, they're starting to move back and forth like that. Just to avoid being shot by anyone that they see or that they may not see. Another good shot there on the fence head glitch. I'm not a big fan of sniping on Nuketown. Nuketown to me is, like, one of those maps... Disgusting shot. Very good. Nuketown to me is one of those maps that it's very beneficial to move up and take control of. A lot of maps in search, you're going to win by getting map control. Went for the quick scope. You got punished for it. Could have just hard scoped him, but I think that's an easy, they consciously wanted to get the quick scope, so it's not something that I can say they made a mistake on where they knew they were making the mistake, you know? Let's fast forward to the next round. Let's talk about that. I wanted to mention. Nuketown is a map where you got to move up and take map control. Because once you lose map control on search and destroy, it's very hard to push up and get to the point where you can arm the bomb. So doing a repeat basically of the last round. I don't really like where the shock charge is placed for one reason. If someone walks up the stairs, I'm having a hard time getting off the person. There we go. If someone walks up the stairs and if they have a headset, they can hear the shock charge, which is fine. But they can shoot it and then run into the room really quick and then shoot him in the back. So it's very simple to get in. If I was going to shock charge something, I'd probably shock charge like on the corner of this wall maybe. Or possibly on the ceiling, something that they wouldn't see as easily. So, it just gives you a better chance of being notified instead of getting killed. Almost got the shot there. Gets that one. I'm actually surprised. Usually don't get the kill, the one-shot kill through the window. So, that was pretty good. See, there they go. You see them pushing up now, and they kind of have map control. At least enough of it to arm on B. Which is really what you need to do on offense in SMD on Nuketown. So. That's a lot more beneficial with shotguns, SMGs, rifles. Not so great with snipers. So I wouldn't suggest that, but I'm not going to harp on them for picking the weapon I wanted to use. So I'm just going to try to evaluate what they're doing with the weapon and give you guys an idea of how they could improve their gameplay. You could improve on this map by getting map control using an SMG or rifle instead of sitting back in the building and sniping. Sniping is usually usually useful on a map that you're kind of given control. But this is not one of those. It isn't on this side anyway. It is on offense. They lost two teammates from the left side. That's why she checked the left there. She's watching the right as well because the green car head glitch is really mean. But no one on their team is really going to it, so she has an advantage. She knows someone's in middle. She or he. This says miss. I don't know. They know someone's in middle. Went for the quick scope again. Didn't get it. Would have hard scoped that or probably would have picked a better vantage point. A better spot that you can sit from the middle. The middle is actually pretty good from here, but you just have a lot of other places you have to look. Another really good spot, though, is down here. If you come down here, you can kind of watch middle, or if you lay down on the carpet here, you can see their feet under the truck, so you know where they're going to be. Both work very well if you're trying to watch the middle, though. Let's fast forward to the next round. So, lesson to learn there. Make sure you have a good vantage point, and don't go for the quickscope unless you are very, very, very good at sniping. It seems like Black Ops 2, everyone thinks they're good at sniping, but not everyone actually is. Me included. I'm not saying I'm outside that, so. Alright, now you have easy sight on Nuketown. Sniping's a little bit easier over here, better, because you don't really have to push up and grab map control. You pretty much are given map control, which, in my opinion, doesn't make a good SMD map, but it's not too bad because the middle bomb site is pretty even. Not greatly even, but pretty even. I'd probably say 60-40 in terms of who has the favorable side, and defense has the favorable of the 60, so. A few people on their team moved up, though, and they have map control, it looks like. A lot of the guys sat back and kind of gave it seceded map control, so it's very easy now for a sniper to pretty much hold people at bay and keep them away from arming. Good shot, hit marker, though. It's kind of what you get with the ballista. Cycle around here. Heglitch. Ooh, I don't know if I'd push up. Unless I would. Oh my god, you just missed him. Oh, shouldn't have shot that. Shouldn't have shot that at all. So what they should have done here, in a good scenario, is since you've kept them off of this side of the map, you're able to push up to this point right here. And if you sit right here, you're able to watch if anyone walks in front of you. You're able to watch if anyone walks across. Just basically anywhere. Watch this line of sight. You can cover anywhere from right there all the way across the map to this point. And they have to walk in front of you. So you're able to know where people go at that point. You can lock them off inside the house. It's an advantage, really. Now they're pushing up with a pistol. You're kind of stuck in the corner. Gets the C4, though. One of the reasons I hate that fucking thing. Must be using flak jacket as well. I think so. Maybe. I don't know. He's lightweight, maybe. I don't know. That was really surprising to survive the bouncing Betty right here. So look where the bouncing Betty is. Oh, I guess they got away. They got quite a distance. I don't know. That's close. That's really close to the death zone. It's definitely the right height, but I'm not sure that the distance. They might have gotten very lucky on the distance right there. Still, I wouldn't have pushed up this far with a pistol sniper combo. Like you basically had control of the map. All you had to do was sit there and wait for him. So unless you're just impatient or you just want to end the round early, you know, you're going for quicker rounds. Gets a hit marker there. Gotta be careful. They're always gonna sit in the back of the spawn. If you want to go safer route here, instead of walking out the bottom, which is usually a bad idea, go inside and go up the stairs, and you're able to get a lot safer of an area. You know, you can see anyone under the desk really easily. If they're in the corner, you'll see that. If you run in here in the corner, if they're not in the house, it's a guarantee they're in the back of the spawn. Or your teammate messed up and they walked past them. But
good job, Seals. You get my point. Ready for the next round.
It's a little bit more dangerous to walk out the bottom and then kind of hope that they're not up. You don't really know. You don't know if they're up top or you don't know in the back. So you get basically stuck in between two places that you could get killed from, but you don't know which one they're going to be in, so you have a really good chance of dying there. It's better to limit your options and make sure that you're not killed. So something I like that I don't see here from this person, if you break the glass, and you jump up on top of it, you're actually able to see into the garage. So you might actually be able to see this person here, and you can definitely see right here. You just have to break the glass and stand on top of it. They're very fixated on the top of the house, but the other team isn't really playing top of the house after the first round, so if you kind of scared them off the top part, you don't really have to worry about consistently watching there every single round. So instead of sitting up there and trying to control it, they just jump down. Again, this is okay. Nice shot there. They're all pushing up together, which is pretty good. They have map control. I would say continue pushing because you have a man-up advantage too. You know, it's 6v2, 6v1. There's a really low chance the other player is going to clutch your whole team. So all pushing up and kind of rushing them isn't a bad deal. And the guy ends up getting killed because he put himself in a bad position. There's no way you can get out of this area once they know you're here. And there's a huge, you know, you're at a huge deficit. You basically lost. But things to look at in this game and to improve from. One, don't quickscope if you can't do it. Unless you're really, really confident. But she died or he died twice. So they would have been 7-0 if they didn't do that. Or possibly 8-0, 9-0 if they got the kills. Number two, I would say lines of sight. A lot of people don't like that, but or don't know it about them. But there's a lot of different lines of sight you can use in this game. And people are still finding new ones. So I would say you might benefit from watching a few videos of other people that are really good players. And you would learn these places. Or playing with really good people, they kind of show you them too. So those two things are the top two in my opinion. The third would be the weapon choice, obviously, like I said. Search and Destroy on Nuketown is a very map-controlled, I guess it centers around map control, at least on offense, defense. If you have offense, it's really hard for you to get it. Defense, you're kind of given it. So defense, sniping's okay. Offense, I would say SMG rifles are going to benefit you more if you want to go for the win. But thank you guys for watching. Hope you enjoyed the video. Hope you learned something. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment. Bye-bye for now, friends.